Hello everyone, myself Dr. Ashwin Santoki. I'm working as an assistant professor at Vanita Vishram Women's College of Commerce, Surat. And today we are going to learn a topic that is written over here, that is selling versus marketing. Now many times what happened, people are getting confused. Actually, what is the difference actually between the selling and marketing? So today we are going to learn some 8 different differences that's define what is the selling and what is the marketing. Let us start. Now first, that is in selling, the first point that is focus on the seller's needs, because the main objective in the selling concept is to sell more, to increase the production and to increase the sales volume and indirectly to earn more profits. But in marketing, it is somewhat different. It focus on consumer needs. So what marketing people do, they will do the market survey, doing research, and then they will identify the consumer's needs and wants and study the needs, and according to that, they will start the production of the particular product or services. So here in selling concept, product is more important, because ultimately they want to increase the sales volume. Ultimately in selling concept, companies are manufacturing those product only which has a low cost of productions, so they can able to sell the products at a lower price in the market. But over here, I already explained the first point, that it focus on consumer needs. So here consumer is more important, because ultimately the objective of marketing is to satisfy the consumers. Third, the high pressures on selling goods. Ultimately, company will force their sales people to increase the sales volume. So there will always be a pressure to sell more in order to gain more profits. But over here, product planning and development is more important. So it tries to match with the consumer's needs. So ultimately, consumer needs are converted into the product. So on the basis of consumer needs, they will start the planning for the product. They will prepare the product in which the consumer's needs and wants are highly satisfied. Fourth difference, that is a fragmented effort to achieve immediate gains. Gains over here means profits, money. And why it is called fragmented approach? Because their objective is to increase the production, sales volume, and ultimately it achieving the higher gains, higher profits. But over here in marketing, it's somewhat different. It is an integrated approach and achieve long-term goals. Why it is called integrated approach? Because generally in marketing, there are 4 P's: product, price, place, and promotions. And all the decisions related to the product, price, place, and promotions are taken simultaneously, and that is why it is called integrated approach. To achieve long-term goals. Now, what is the long-term goal for the marketing? The first is to increase the consumer satisfaction. Second, to increase the loyalty of among consumers and the customers' retentions. So, ultimately, marketing is not focusing more on earning money, but they are focusing more on earning consumers. So they want that consumer become loyal to us, and the retention of the consumers will be done. Number 5, that is converting product into cash. So they are manufacturing product, right? In selling concept, they are manufacturing product and it try to convert into cash. Cash means generally profits and earnings, gains. But in marketing, it's somewhat different. Consumer needs are converted into product. That already we have learned in the previous topics. So how product has been prepared or manufactured based on the consumer needs. So marketing team will identify the consumer needs. They will do the research, right? And on the basis of that, they will prepare the product. So generally, customization should be done over here. And for here, standardizations. Number 6 is again important, a second P, that is price. Cost determine the price. So ultimately, I told you in the previous point that in selling concept, companies always try to manufacture those products which have a low cost of productions. So low cost of productions, and ultimately on the basis of the cost only, they will decide the final MRP price which the consumer is ready to pay. Over here, market determines the price. Now who can be called a market? That can be called as a target consumers. So marketing people will try to study, they do the research about what is the capacity to pay by the consumers. So they will also study the income level, the financial positions, and what is the willingness and capacity of the consumers to buy that particular product on which MRP. Clear? And that is the market, consumers will determine the price. The seventh one, profit to sales volume, right? So ultimately the objective is to increase the sales volume. More volumes are being sold out, ultimately leads to profits. But in marketing, profits to consumer satisfaction is the ultimate objective of the marketing, to satisfy the consumers rather than to increase the money or to rather than increase the profits or gains. So in marketing, generally the main objective or main profits is the customer's satisfaction. And the last one that talks about in selling, consumer is the last link in business, right? So ultimately they are not focusing on customers' needs and wants, and in selling also they are not focusing on the customer satisfaction. So ultimately they focus more on to sales volumes in order to increase the sales, and finally the consumer is ready to purchase. But they are unable to study that after sales, either the consumers or customers are satisfied or not. But it is not there in the marketing one. Marketing is somewhat different. Customer is the very purpose of the business. It means it's the first one. Marketing starts with the consumers. In selling, it's the last link. So after the purchase, the selling process is over. But in marketing, it's a never ending process. It starts continuing. Because once need satisfies, another needs arises. So every new needs again converted into new product and services. So everyone, this is the some basic difference between the selling and the marketing. Now hope that you all are clear. I request you, if you like this video, Rise6 lecture, please like it and subscribe our channel. Thank you so much.